Hello, my name is Ashan.
And my name is Ezray. And this is our final year project.
The Hexapod.
Like with all projects, this project was approached with research. What is a hexapod? What makes it so special? Why does it seem more attractive as a movement method as opposed to wheels?
Hexapods and six-legged robots in general are inspired by insects such as ants. They provide a degree of flexibility not generally accessible to movements we are used to, such as wheels. Since the robots can actually be stable on three legs or more, a hexapod can move even if one of the legs becomes disabled. If the legs are not being used for stability, they can be used for manipulating the surroundings or even their own body.
The main outcomes for this robot was to achieve a functioning hexapod that allowed movement by the user, as well as a video feed that allowed the user to survey an area not normally accessible to humans. In addition to this, the robot had to be able to overcome obstacles that it may face in general use, such as stairs and beams.
The final product of this project was found to complete our outcomes. With some additional features and functions, it was determined that six-legged movement, while lacking in some aspects such as speed, does provide a high degree of flexibility in terms of maneuverability. The following section of the video outlines the design, production, and the testing of the robot in more detail.
Design of the robot was done primarily with SolidWorks, where 3D models were created with the intention of either 3D printing or laser cutting. The legs can be broken down into three sections: the coxa, the femur, and tibia. The coxa and femur were to be assembled with metal brackets that came with the servos, whereas the tibia here was 3D printed. The body, on the other hand, was laser cut out of an acrylic sheet. The skeleton was then assembled using M3 screws and nuts.
The controller was designed in a very similar way. The body and the skeleton was laser cut, and the buns and the sides of the controller were 3D printed. Once this was done, the controller was finally assembled using screws and nuts. We then moved on to designing the electronics.
Electronic design began with breadboards. For the hexapod, this meant with a singular servo. After the movements were found, we expanded to include more servos. After this, the electronics were soldered to a Vera board for testing of the robot. The servos used were RDS3115 Metal Gear servos that were capable of producing 15 kilograms per centimeter of torque.
For communication between the controller and the robot, NRF24L01 chips were used. These used 2.4 gigahertz radio frequencies and used an SPI system with a start byte, ID byte, and a data byte. These were also tested using breadboards and were later ported onto a Vera board.
The power for the hexapod and controller came from two LiPo batteries. They produced 16 volts at full charge and provided power to all their components. Through step-down components such as buck converters and regulators, we reached the desired voltages of 12, 5, and 3.3 volts.
After electronic design was complete, testing of gates, walking, and obstacle maneuvering had to begin. This started with individual legs, which incorporated three servos. Then all legs were adapted to move the hexapod as one system. The leg movement was created by a mathematic function that output a set of angles that corresponded to a quadratic arc of the leg and a linear movement of the leg. Then the angles were placed into a separate function that converted the angles to PWM values for the servos.
Testing for obstacles was done by individually coding movements to achieve a stable and efficient way to overcome these obstacles. Testing overall went well and took up the vast majority of the project. There were some issues that cropped up with stability. The issue of stability came from the 3D printed legs being too slippery on the surface of many areas. This was solved by adding rubber stubs to the end of the toe. At the conclusion of testing, there were main movements created for the robot to move forward, backward, rotate left, and rotate right. There were also obstacle gates that allowed the robot to overcome a beam type obstacle, up and down stairs, and even navigate under a beam. In addition to this, there was also ways built to increase or decrease the height of the robot.
After testing was completed, work began on designing and creating the PCBs. Within the earlier stages of the project, we utilized a variboard as the core for the robot. It sufficed for a large period as we did testing. However, as further complexities were being introduced, a variboard simply wouldn't be enough. On top of the signals to the servos, as well as the power for the PSOC and the servos, additional components such as the NRF chip and the camera needed to be added to progress. This was completed using a program called Altium. To reduce the cluster as well as eliminate potential faults, a PCB needed to be designed and manufactured. The initial stages of the design included brainstorming all the components which needed to be included to reach the level of functionality which was desired. Once the components were finalized, a schematic of the PCB was created with the custom footprint assigned to the collected components. PCBs were finalized and produced by PCBWay.com, a reliable PCB manufacturer in China. The board was produced with the basic specifications and delivered to us. Parts were accrued either from Monash University stores or JCAR and soldered together.
After PCBs were implemented, there were issues that had cropped up, which resulting in having to implement circuit protection to protect circuit components such as the NRFs and PSOC. It was found that upon turning the robot and hexapod off with switches, there were surges that traveled through the boards. This was fixed with the addition of Zener diodes. There were two Zener diodes connected, a 5-volt and a 3.3-volt diode. They were connected from over the positive terminals to ground. A Zener diode works in the way that if a voltage exceeded either 3.3 volts or 5 volts, it would short the board to ensure the voltage surge or any other issue would not touch the components. In addition, it was also found that there were some missing connections within the PCB. However, this was easily fixed by soldering wires straight to the PCB. Finally, there were some inconsistencies with the functionality of the robot. This was diagnosed due to inefficiencies in the code, particularly from interrupts. These problems were all identified with the use of a UART, debugging from the PSOC, and digital oscilloscopes, as well as multimeters. Vision for the robot, or rather the video feed fed from the robot to a screen on the controller, was adapted from a drone FPV system and reverse camera screen. Signals sent from the camera to the screen is done through radio frequency.
The lowest point of this project came towards the end, right before the implementation of the circuit protection. It was a constant issue that ended up being a frustrating endeavor, which was a result of everything working on its own, but having shortcomings when implemented as a complete system. This taught us that the issues in engineering are not always specific to electrical engineering. We realized how much persistence and the ability to stay positive really play a vital part in effectively completing the project.
This led to the things that we learned. Apart from the obvious practical skills that have been improved, such as coding, designing, and learning new programs such as Altium, there was a bigger and highly more important skill developed, which was problem solving. The basic job of an engineer from any discipline is the ability to solve problems. That's what we do. Learning to break down an issue into sections, from power to components, wiring, and finally software, is a skill both Ashan and I have developed and found over the lifetime of this project.
In terms of what we would do differently if we were given another chance to complete a project, is to prototype a lot better. Prototyping using even just a breadboard is an underrated task and is seen to be tedious, but towards the end proves to be a powerful tool to ensure the successful completion of the project. Also, another thing which we came to realize is the power of tools such as oscilloscope when it comes to troubleshooting.
Future steps of this project are fairly numerous. One obvious addition would be the ability to rotate the camera to provide more freedom from direct sight of the robot. In addition to this, more cameras would be implemented to give an almost 360 degree view. A further step to this could be the implementation of computer vision. This would allow the robot to identify certain obstacles and allow for autonomous exploration. In conclusion, this project has been one of the most challenging but rewarding of our university experience. It taught us from the beginning how to face adversity and how to overcome problems. Furthermore, it gave us confidence and the ability to take these ideas and knowledge we have learned further on in our lives. Thank you.
Thank you.